Hey there, it's Renee from Design Plus School. Welcome to my tutorial. So today, we will learn an easy parallax with prototype in Figma, like this. If I go from the star, so we can see the tree is actually zoom in and the mountain is zoom out. And what's more interesting is that make a time lapse in the same time.
Whoa.
Is it crazy, guys? So let's get started and see how it's done. Parallax scrolling is an animation technique where the background and the foreground content move at different speed. For example, the foreground are the street and the mountain and sky are the background. To make a parallax, they should move differently, like this. To make this animation, I use Smart Animate with Prototype here on the Prototype tab. You can of course prototype with Sketch or it will work as well. What is Prototype? Figma prototyping feature allow you to create interactive flow that explore how a user may interact with you in design. Prototype are a fantastic way to preview interaction and user flow. Is the only way to practice your app. With Figma, we can do a lot of things. That's so cool. Let me give you an example of all the prototypes that I made that I use Smart Animate. This is parallax and time lapse. This one is the same. So this one uses parallax scrolling. This one is a hover. While you're hovering your mouse, it's hovering like this. Same thing for this one. So it's very fun. The first step that you need to do is to have your design built. So it's important to have two frame, two design for now. My tutorial is about parallax, so I choose the mountain to make parallax effect. So the first design is, and the second one is the night. The second frame should be different depending on how you want your animation finish. You can take any image you want to edit, cut or mask yourself with either Photoshop or any tool, but it's better to design yourself if you can and play with the layer as you want. By the way, this design is made by my co-worker Axamity. All of her design is just amazing. When you prototype, you will need another frame to connect the animation together. So we're gonna duplicate the frame and we're gonna change and make the design different. Which means I'm gonna change the foreground and the background differently and transform the morning to become a night portrait to make like a timeline. So let's do that. I'm gonna duplicate this frame. I'm gonna transform the second frame. I'm gonna transform a night. So I prepare the color here. I'm just gonna do it quickly. So I'm just gonna copy, paste the color that I prepared already. I'm gonna make it fast. I'm gonna change only the background mountain. The background mountain is gonna change the color like this. I don't change too much color. It's fine like that. I'm gonna add the star. Copy paste. I'm gonna make at the top like that. But make sure the star should be in the bottom. Oh no, after. Sorry. Now I'm gonna take the mountain. I'm gonna take only the background mountain. I'm gonna hide a little bit like that. And I can make this tree a little bit bigger like this. Go down a little bit. Same thing with this one. Okay, for this one I'm gonna make smaller and bring a little bit at the left. And now I'm gonna make the foreground mountain bigger a little bit like that. When you're satisfied with your design, we can start to prototype. Here the tab tool. We have design tab that you create your design. Then we have prototype tab that you animate and practice your apps here, and inspect tab that you will have all the code that you can copy for CSS. Once you're satisfied with your prototype, click the play icon to open your presentation view in a new tab. Now, select the prototype, select the first frame, and here is the connection node, which means the connection is ready to begin. Just drag the arrow to the second frame, then choose the interaction on after delay. If you want to make a parallax effect, it's after delay. For 800 milliseconds is okay. And now for the animations, choose smart animate. So the rest is fine. Let's play the play icon here. Let's see if it's worked. Oh, great. Let's try again. See, it's become a night. I should fix the street a little bit, but it's not a big deal. Now the parallax is done. But I would like to add something more elegant to make more attractive. So I'm gonna make a parallax scrolling. So when you scroll, we can see the content appear on the top. So let's duplicate this second frame. Let's bring everything a little bit on the top. So when you scroll down, it should be like this. It should be on the another page. I just show you quickly. I'm not gonna do it perfectly. When you scroll down, we're gonna see the content here. This is an example. Let's make center, put a little bit like this. And let's add some illustration that I prepared already. This is from Axon Ready. Now, it's more perfect. Let's put bun here and I put header. The header gonna appear after. Let's try. Bring this layer in the top right here. Something like that. So the third design is done. So let's prototype together. The first frame I already connect to the second frame that I made a parallax effect that I choose after delay. For the third frame, I would like to make a scroll. When we click on this button, it's gonna scroll down. And this illustration will appear on the top. Let's connect this button, drag to the third frame, click. When you click, it's gonna scroll. And the animation will be smart animate because it makes a smooth animation. Okay, let me change this one a little bit. I would like to put 100 milliseconds. So let's see if it's work. Oh, perfect. And let's try the button if it's work. It's gonna be scrolling. Perfect. So that's it for today. If you wanna practice your app, use prototype because it's very easy to animate whatever you want. I actually always use Smart Animate because it makes a smooth animation for you, very quick and easy and fast. So don't forget, use your design, prototyping, connection between frame, choose your animation and play. Boom! That's it. Nothing complicated. So hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, and give me a big thumbs up. So see you on the next video. Bye guys!